Sandy Pandy and Looby Loo. Happy as he can be, Teddy too. Playing in the garden every day, making things so much fun.
One afternoon, Andy Pandy wondered what he might find in his special cupboard. Andy had never seen this box before. What could be inside? Andy wanted to know why there was a handle on the box, so he turned it. Teddy had come to see if Andy had any spare food to be eaten up, but Andy wanted to show him the box he'd just found. Teddy thought the girl who lived in the box was very pretty, but what did she do? Andy stopped turning the handle and let it go. It was a musical box. Andy and Teddy had never seen a musical box before. Now they knew what the girl who lived in the box did. She danced to the music. Andy and Teddy wanted to dance as well. The girl who lived in the...
Were the stars shining, the sun, or the moon? The sun! Well done!
Hooray! The box danced round and round and never felt dizzy. But Andy and Teddy soon felt dizzy. Never mind. They were both thrilled by the musical box and the dancer who lived inside. Andy wanted to show the box to Looby Loo. Looby was just as thrilled by the musical box as Andy and Teddy. She couldn't wait to see the girl who lived in the box dance to the music. And Andy couldn't wait to show her. Andy didn't want Teddy to feel dizzy and fall over again, but Looby Loo could dance to the music without feeling dizzy at all. Looby Loo danced even more beautifully than the girl who lived in the box. She couldn't stop. She just danced and danced. Soon everyone else heard the music and came to see what was going on. They all thought Looby Loo and the girl who lived in the box danced beautifully. Missy Hissy wished she could dance like Looby Loo and the girl who lived in...
A flower, a lily pad, or an apple? A lily pad, of course!
In the box, and so did everyone else. Bilbo the Sailor said his dancing days were over, but asked Looby if she would teach the others to dance. Looby said they must have a moonlit ball on the green that very evening. Missy Hissy loved dancing with Looby Loo, but as snakes don't have any legs, she couldn't learn the steps. Orby the Ball didn't find dancing very easy either. Every time Looby tried to teach him, he rolled straight out of her arms. Teddy had just the right number of legs and feet and wanted to show Looby and Andy what a fine dancer he could be. But he had wound the handle far...
On the potting shed, on the stable, or on the twisty tree? On the twisty tree! That's right! Yay! Come on!
Too quickly. And he was very glad when the music slowed down. And the musical box stopped playing. Teddy felt a bit odd and went to have a lie down before the moonlit ball. Looby Loo went to Tiffo's house to teach him how to dance. But Tiffo soon found that dancing wasn't as easy as it looked. He followed Looby with his front legs, but he'd forgotten to move his back legs. And he got in a terrible tangle. Andy Pandy was ready for his lesson. And Looby showed him how to move to the music. Andy was enjoying himself. He was ready to dance with Looby Loo. Andy and Looby danced beautifully together. They couldn't stop dancing. They danced all afternoon and into the evening. They danced all around Andy Pandy's garden, and they danced onto the green.
On Mimi's tree stump, on Horace's lily pad, or on my water bowl? You're right, on Mimi's tree stump!
Their friends came to the moonlit ball and were very happy to watch Andy and Looby dancing together. Teddy brought the musical box with him and turned the handle. This time he made sure he turned the handle gently, so the music just played and played. Soon, the moon came out and shone on the girl who lived in the musical box and shone on Andy Pandy and Looby Loo.